Looking to classify matter into substance and mixture, or to classify them even further into element, compound, homogeneous mixture, and heterogeneous mixture? Then you're at the right place. Hi, I'm Dr. K, and welcome to ChemSimplified. In this video, we'll go through how to classify matter into element, compound, homogeneous mixture, and heterogeneous mixture by asking simple questions. I'll illustrate how to do it using several examples. First thing first. What is matter? It's the stuff that makes up all material things, and it takes up space and has mass. Now that we know what matter is, let's move on to see how it is classified. Matter can be split into two groups, substance and mixture. Substance is a pure matter, it has definite or fixed composition. That means you know exactly what it is made out of. You'll be able to provide the chemical formula for it. Mixture, just like what its name states, it's a mixture of two or more substances which are mixed physically. This means each of these substances will retain their identities, so they don't combine to become something else. This is really the key point here. Going back to substance, it can be further classified into element and compound. Element is the most elemental substance. It cannot be broken down further chemically. Compound, on the other hand, is made out of two or more elements which were combined chemically. Mixture can be classified into two categories, homogeneous mixture and heterogeneous mixture. Homogeneous mixture is mixed well. When you see homogeneous mixture, you only see one thing. Whereas for heterogeneous mixture, you can see the mixture is uneven. You see more than one thing. All this will become clearer when we discuss with examples. Just hang in there for a little bit. To simplify the classification of matter, we can ask simple questions that will help us classify the matter correctly. So when given a matter to classify, the first question we should ask is, does it have fixed composition? Meaning, do we know exactly what it is made out of? Are we able to provide the chemical formula for that matter? If yes, then that matter is a substance. Then we can further classify it by asking another question, which is, does it contain more than one type of atom? So the key point here to keep in mind is that we are asking whether it has more than one type. Type, not number of atom. If it has more than one type of atom, answer is yes, then it should be classified as compound. Otherwise, if it only has one type of atom, it should be classified as element. Now back to having fixed composition. So if it doesn't have a fixed composition, meaning we are not able to provide an exact chemical formula or exact composition for that matter, then it should be classified as a mixture. And then to further classify our mixture, we ask whether the composition is uniform. That means the whole thing, is it mixed really well, where you cannot differentiate one substance from another? If yes, then it's a homogeneous mixture. If it's not mixed well, then it's a heterogeneous mixture. So let's start with our first example, sodium, Na. So the first question we ask is, does it have fixed composition? Well, yes, the answer is yes, because we know that it is sodium. Well, sodium has a chemical symbol of Na, so our answer to this question is yes. So therefore, sodium is a substance. Now, if you need to further classify it beyond substance, then we would ask the next question, which is, does it contain more than one type of atom? So looking at the formula, it's only Na, so that's one type of atom. So the answer is no. Therefore, sodium is an element. Okay, let's move on with our second example. Salt, NaCl. So same question, does it have fixed composition? Yes, we know the chemical formula, it's NaCl, so it's a substance. And then we ask the next question, which is, does it contain more than one type of atom? Yes, because we have Na and Cl, that's two types of atom. So the answer is yes. So therefore, salt, NaCl, is a compound. Moving on, saline. Does it have a fixed composition? Well, saline is actually salt water. It's a combination of NaCl plus H2O. So there's no exact formula for salt water, meaning salt water that is prepared by one person will differ from another person. So the ratio of NaCl to H2O is not fixed. It varies from person to person or from salt water to salt water. So therefore, it doesn't have a fixed composition. So it's a mixture. Now, if we need to further classify this, then we ask the next question. Is the composition uniform? So look at that glass of salt water. Does it look like it's just one thing? Or does it look like it's a little bit different on the top or on the side or at the bottom of the glass? No, right? It looks exactly the same throughout. So the composition is uniform. So therefore, it's a homogeneous mixture. Last but not least, this is a combination of salt and sand mixed together. So does it have a fixed composition? Of course not, because we're not going to be able to tell how much salt is in there, how much sand is in there. We can't provide an exact percentage of the type of salt and the type of sand that's present in there. So therefore, it's a mixture. And then we ask the next question, which is the composition uniform? Is it mixed well? Well, look at it. Do you see like some specks of white color here and there, and then some darker specks here and there, and some lighter in between colors? It's not mixed really well, right? I mean, some parts has lighter color, some parts have darker color. So the composition is not uniform. Therefore, it's a heterogeneous mixture. Here's a summary of the flowchart that we can easily use to classify elements by asking simple questions. If you enjoyed this video and feel that it is helpful in classifying matter, give a thumbs up or share it with your friends. Subscribe so you won't miss out on new videos. Head over to ChemSimplified.com for practice questions. I'll post the blog link in the description box below. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.